public without makeup, but I just had a really intense dream and I felt like the Lord said to share it before the intensity goes away. Guys, pray for me. I'm starting to have very specific dreams of who's going to be left behind and who's going to heaven. By all means, I'm not the judge. I'm just getting warnings so I can pray for people and talk to people, but please pray for me to have wisdom. I'm not sure who to tell and who not to tell what. I know I need to warn people. I just had a flashback of my childhood, and someone was getting ready to get the motorhome to go home. It was time to go home. And so we were all preparing to go home, and I went to a Christian bookstore to just review some final things and some Christian books with some dear friends and believers that I recognized. And then it was time to go, and we were walking in the parking lot, and the person I was with was like, "Where's my car?" And that just kind of showed where the priorities were. And then I knew that the angels were there to take me, and I started yelling, "Somebody help me, help me," and no one could hear me anymore. And the person was that I was with looked at me, and he couldn't see me anymore, and the angel said, "Go ahead, like punch him in the stomach," but I wouldn't do that. It was just that it's gonna hit him in the gut, and we'll just want to touch their face and say goodbye. And then I saw a very, very bright light, and "We'll be gone," the angel said. It was time to go. I knew they were there to take me. And a bee, yesterday I killed a bee because it was gonna sting my boy, so I had to do it, but I felt so awful. And I know the Lord doesn't take the death of anyone lightly, and I just felt so awful. But I saw the bee go through the brightest light in my dream. I kept saying, "Is this real? Is this happening now? Is this real?" It was so real. The light was so bright. And the bee was going through the light and will be gone too soon. People turn to the Lord and get serious. A class in my dream that we were in, a dear sister was teaching us. Many will say, "Lord, Lord." Romans 10:9 says, "If you confess me as Lord, you will be saved." But many in the last day will say, "Lord, Lord." It's not just saying Lord, it's making Jesus the Lord of your life and following him and being born of the Spirit, as it says in John 3. Follow the Lord. Keep following the Lord, brothers and sisters, and warn the beloved. Beloved, warn your loved ones. Thank you, Jesus, for your love, that you don't take anything lightly. Lead us, Lord Jesus. Amen.